Hi everybody, it's Austin. Today we're celebrating the 2021 Battle of the Books Best of Battle, presented to you by DTDL and the Grenledge Area District Library. I'm here to recommend some additional reads that you may want to check out if you particularly enjoyed reading our battle books this year. Today we're talking about Rita Likes for Green Glass House by Kate Milford. First, you'll be happy to know that the adventures and mysteries of Green Glass House, the Blue Crown family, and the Smugglers of Nagspeak continue in The Ghosts of Green Glass House, Blue Crown, and The Thief Knot. Also, the book of local folklore that Milo reads, the Raconteurs Commonplace book, is being published on its own soon, so be sure to check that out. Next, I want to recommend a few books that fit into the subgenre that I have titled Books About Unlikely Groups of Quirky Characters Stuck in Mysterious Historical Buildings. To start, I'd like to recommend to you the classic example, The Westing Game by Ellen Raskin. A strange real estate agent carefully selects and interviews buyers for rooms in an apartment building owned by the enigmatic millionaire Sam Westing. When Mr. Westing dies under mysterious circumstances, it is revealed that all of the building tenants have been named heirs to his estate, but they must compete against one another in a game of puzzles and riddles to claim it. As the treasure hunt commences, the secret connections between the tenants and Mr. Westing begin to come to light, and the stakes of the Westing game are raised higher than anyone expected. You may also enjoy The Mysterious Benedict Society, which, as the title implies, is about a mysterious society. Rainy Muldoon lives at Stonetown Orphanage, where, at the suggestion of his tutor, he responds to an ad in the newspaper asking for the assistance of talented and gifted kids. In response, he is sent a series of bizarre puzzles and riddles. He solves them all, as do three other kids, and is asked to join the titular Benedict Society in an effort to save the world. The leader of this society believes that secret brainwashing messages have been encoded into radio signals being broadcast from the Learning Institute for the Very Enlightened. Rainey and his teammates enroll into the boarding school to gather information, and they uncover a plot that threatens the world. This is also a series, so if you like it, you'll have plenty of material to read through. Next, I have the first book in the Greystone Secret series by Margaret Peterson Haddix, The Strangers. Chess, Emma, and Finn Greystone know who they are and how they fit into their family. Or at least, they thought they did, until they hear a report of three kidnapped children who share their first and middle names and their birthdays. Suddenly, their mother leaves town, and the Greystone children are left behind with a series of coded riddles that lead them on a hunt for hidden rooms and dangerous secrets. There are currently three books in this series, so again, you'll have plenty to read here. Finally, I have the Winter House series by Ben Gooderson. Emma Summers has been shipped off to live at the Winter House Hotel by her aunt and uncle. It's under the care of a strange, scary man named Norbridge Falls, but Emma still comes to love the hotel, especially its library. While browsing its shelves, she uncovers a seemingly magical book of puzzles that begin to reveal the sinister history of Norbridge's family, the residents of the hotel, the building, and Emma's own personal connection to it. Thankfully, this is also a series, so there are three books in total to date, and you'll never have to wait in suspense for what happens next. So, those are my recommendations for what to read next if you enjoyed Green Glass House by Kate Milford. For more information on this year's Battle of the Books events, check out our battle page on our website at dtdl.org. Thanks guys, keep reading, and I'll see you next time.